Okay, I wanted to show you my latest plugin. This is for a plugin for Chronicle, and it allows you to automate the printing of your Planning Center online paperwork. So let's check it out. So here in Chronicle, this is my home page. I'm going to go over to the admin section, and then I'm going to click plugins. And you can see all the plugins I currently have here in Chronicle. And I'm going to click on PCO Print, which is my one that we're going to show you here today. So this is the plugin. And I've named it PCO Print, and it is enabled. This is the path to the executable. So it's just a simple Python script, and it has these parameters. It has the IP and the port of the computer running Vicryo Listener. So what this plugin actually does is it sends the correct URL that needs to be requested from Planning Center Online to print the paperwork, and it will open up Safari on your computer and download the PDF to a specific folder. And then we have a folder action in Automator that every time a PDF gets added to that folder, it will print it automatically. So you do need to specify a PCO app ID and secret key. You can get this in the Planning Center developer section of Planning Center Online. I've blacked it out here so that I can keep those secret because they are like passwords, so you don't want to give those out to anybody. Then you do need to specify your service type, and you can actually include multiple if you delimit them by semicolons. So I want to print two different service types with my paperwork. And so if you want to get your service type IDs, like these two here, just go to Planning Center, and then over here under Service Type, come over here to the Settings wheel, choose Settings. And you'll see the service type up here in the URL. So that's my first one there. You can see that it matches here. And then I did that for my other service type as well. So for me, that's Auditorium 1 and Auditorium 2. You also need to include the custom report ID. And so this is my report ID here. Again, to get that in Planning Center, you would go to Reports. So this, for me, this is a matrix report. And so this is my matrix view, and I'll just say print, and then you'll want to say edit custom reports. And the one that I'm using is matrix report, and it's called Tech Team Master Print 2020. If I click on that, you'll see the ID is right up here in the URL. And so I've taken that and included it right here as a parameter. And then these last three parameters are just page size, print orientation, and print margin. And that's just kind of the default settings that we like to use. I usually use US letter, portrait, and then I like the margins to be 0.25 inch on either side. And so when you put all of this in and then schedule it, it will run this script. So let me show you that Python script here. This is what it looks like. It will take all of the parameters that you provided from Chronicle. And it loops through, uses the API, and it grabs the plan IDs, the first plan ID of each service type in your list. And then it builds the query string that Planning Center needs to make that report. And it creates this entire PDF path, which it then sends via Vicryo Listener to your remote computer and opens it up in Safari to download that PDF. So if you look, this is my computer. This is the remote computer I've got running Vicryo Listener. It will receive a shell command, which opens Safari with this exact long URL. Now I've set Safari to automatically download anything to this automated printing folder. That works for me because I don't really use Safari as a regular browser on this computer. We use Chrome. And so I've just decided to dedicate Safari to this purpose. And then I have a folder action set here in Automator. If you've never used Automator, it's a very powerful tool on macOS for doing all kinds of things automatically. And so it says anytime a file or folder is added to this specific folder, it's going to filter the Finder items by making sure their file extensions are PDF. And then it runs a shell script. So it loops through all the added files. And this is the cups command line printing command. And it just prints each file, waits for 5 seconds, and then it deletes the file. And so that's what this plugin does. So here's a quick video of it in action.
All right, here I am in the control room.
looking here on the clock, it's just about 6 o'clock. And when that hits 6 o'clock, I've got a lot of events that are going to run, one of which is printing out my planning center paperwork. So here we go, and it's 6 o'clock. Now this computer is going to open up Safari, download a PDF, puts it in my automated printing folder. Anything that goes in that folder will automatically print out to my printer. You can hear the printer start to work. And there it comes. And it's done. Now look, my auditoriums are already turning themselves on. I love automation.